I was chatting with a Catholic friend, and he told me, he asked me, who represents you all? We have the Pope, we have a hierarchy, we have a group of people whom we can say they are our representative. The World Evangelical Alliance is the closest we have to that.
In 1960, we were about 90 million evangelicals in the world. 60 years later, we've gone from 90 million to over 600 million evangelicals. And during that time, developing around the world have been all these national alliances. And today, we have 130.
The World Evangelical Alliance is an organization, a ministry that God has established for more than 170 years. We try to make sure that our vision and our mission is clear, our strategic directions are there, of establishing and strengthening national alliances so that they can serve the churches.
We represent the evangelical churches in this nation, and we are the representative voice of the evangelicals to the government, to the media, to other forums as well. If Jesus was the president of this country, what would the indicators be? Individual and corporate righteousness, economic sufficiency, social peace, and public justice.
In a sense, we are a spiritual United Nations. Our diversity, our cultural, ethnic mosaic helps us to speak with authenticity to global issues. The evangelical family is doing tremendous things all over the world. It's just that many times we are doing them in silos. We are doing them away from each other. If we're to come together, as they say, you know, more powerful together. For instance, if there was one part of the world which needed a particular intervention, can you imagine if we brought all of our best minds, best resources, best funders, just to deal with that area? The impact we would make in certain areas will be absolutely phenomenal. One of the things I really want to see in the WEA is the emergence of younger ministers or younger leaders. And that's why, for instance, the Global Leadership Institute, I think, will be a fantastic vehicle in which we can process those younger persons so that they can be trained, groomed, mentored.
So our development of this Global Institute was to find best practices, go to the countries that we all agree are some of the finest, creative leadership, proper funding, good program, theologically solid, all the right elements. And to take those and demonstrate those to others, and to help others see what they could be, what can be done. And then to build training modules. Without having to bring them physically, we can bring people around the world instantly, any time of the day, to help learn from each other.
One of the genius of this Leadership Development Institute is it is not one size fits it all. We want to tailor fit it to the context, to the situation, and we would like to help to ask the regions, the regional leaders to come and help us, because from there they can help us cascade it down to the national alliances.